Joining me today is Audrey Ryan from Aegon to talk about women in investing.
Good afternoon.
Hi there, Audrey. So we are thinking about women, the city, the investment world, and how to get women investing more and taking control of their financial futures. I thought I'd start by asking you how you came into the world of investing.
Yeah, well, I in my, I guess, latter part of senior school, I started doing accountancy, very much enjoyed it, and then progressed to do an accounting degree at university, and then moved on to do a chartered accountancy qualification. And I guess I'd shown an interest in all those years in finance and following equity markets. And then once I'd qualified and had 2 years experience within accountancy, I looked for an opportunity in investment and fund management, and was fortunate enough to move into the industry in 1995. And I can quite honestly say I have enjoyed the last two decades, and no 2 days have ever been the same in my day-to-day work environment. So very much enjoy what I do.
That seems there an early focus in finance, which isn't always the case with women who find themselves in this industry. What was it about finance, about maths, about investing that so got you hooked?
Yeah, well, I think in the very early days, my father was quite interested in investing and following markets. So I think part of that rubbed off on me. So I took a little bit of an interest in that. And then I very distinctly remember on an October midterm break, the entire family went to London, and we were taken to the London Stock Exchange, and very, very much recall that. And, you know, that stays with me till this day. And I guess, you know, throughout the time, just continue to read and evolve my interest in investing and kept a pace with the market. So, you know, quite early on, I would say I established that kind of relationship and interest, and just kept moving with it.
And you've mentioned that you've been in this world since 1995. I mean, still female fund managers are very much in the minority. But back then, it must have been even more so. Were you often the only woman, not just in the room, but in the building?
Well, I guess in my chartered accountancy days, I worked for, you know, a very strong female individual. She was my manager. I would say she was my mentor. And it was slightly different in terms of gender diversity within that. But she was a very driven, motivated individual. And actually, she made it to become the first partner in that accountancy practice. And when I moved into fund management, I was part of a team. There were other female fund managers there. And I think the ratio is still very much the same today within the team within which I work. So, you know, things have not changed in terms of percentage in our UK team. But, you know, we have continued to, throughout the business, I would say the agenda on diversity in its widest sense, not just gender and inclusion, has been something that we've been working on over, you know, the last number of years throughout the business, from, you know, the colleagues, my colleagues on the floor, right up to the board level. So yeah, things have, I think things have evolved within the industry for the good. But I, you know, I see, you know, similar issues in other industries. It's not just fund management and investment.
Now, that forward thinking that you've mentioned, that you've been so lucky to be a beneficiary of in having that gender mix, really also plays into your specialism as a fund manager, doesn't it? Because thinking about diversity, we always think that that is the S of ESG. And of course, ESG is fundamental to the way that you invest in the ethical fund. Do you think that's helped to be part of a company that puts ESG at the forefront of their investment process, and therefore perhaps in the way that they think about running the business too?
Yeah, I absolutely think that it is central to what we do. You know, we've been running ethical type monies for, you know, more than 30 years. We've continued to develop and evolve our offering on responsible investing across all our asset classes. And I guess the learnings that we took from, you know, back in the early 90s in terms of, you know, thinking about environmental, social and governance aspect has benefited the entire business, I think has benefited our clients, but also benefited the way that we as a company have evolved and developed. And I would say, you know, all for the good.
Now, looking at the data for women and men in investing, there is no denying the fact that women do not invest as much as men. Their pension pots tend to be smaller, and therefore their financial independence is less secure. So what top tips would you give our female clients or prospective female investors in order to take charge?
Yeah. Well, I guess I'd start off by saying that, you know, thinking about, you know, one's financial future is important for us all, not just, you know, by gender. And I guess probably five key things I would highlight. And, you know, very honestly, I didn't know all these things when I started out. It has been, a learning curve in some of these aspects. But I guess, firstly, my key point would be to, you know, start saving and investing as early as one can. It will reap the benefits, absolutely. Two, I would say planning. Think about planning. You know, make investing or saving part of your monthly budget. Don't, you know, just take it from what's left off at the end. Plan for that type of saving. And, you know, even if it's just quite modest amounts at the start, getting into that routine, I think, is really, really important. And then do one's homework. And, you know, there's lots of information out there that one can read, access. Much of it is jargon-free and, you know, makes it, I guess, less confusing and less complex for certain investors out there. And, you know, if you think it's the right thing for you, then seek financial advice. You know, that is the solution for a number of individuals. Patience is also something I think is important. So, you know, one has to plan, prepare, but also having patience, I think, is one thing that people should, you know, think about, because ultimately for many, this is quite a long game. We are investing for perhaps retirement or later stages in life. And I guess the final point I would make is to think very carefully about diversification, whether that be by geography, sector, or indeed by asset class. You know, no one wants to put all their eggs in one basket, or shouldn't want to, in my view. So, you know, I think it's good to think about, you know, one's tolerance to risk and what your own financial objective and target is for the future. Because, as we know, everyone is different. The starting point is different and the end objective may be different.
Audrey, thank you very much.
Thank you.